I was born in sin.
And my language is wholly, wholly different. But I have adapted myself to many linguistic changes. But I'm afraid I have not been able to pick up this somewhat difficult language of yours. Kindly do pardon me. I am seeking the apology not merely of the president of the party, the KCB party, for which and its ideology I have got great respect and admiration, but I have not come here to speak politics. I have come here to seek your forgiveness for what I think is some kind of a crime that I have committed in life, for which I need to be punished. My friends, India is a poor country. The poverty was always the result of alien rule. They made themselves rich, and the Indian people remained poor. But my friends, something has happened to India through the instrumentality of Indians themselves. But I must tell you some few preliminary facts. The United Nations has been struggling with the problem of black money and the misery and the poverty that is created by the theft of that money for nearly 4 years, from 2000 to 2004. In 2004, the United Nations evolved a whole act. They called it, what shall I tell you? They called it a new convention against corruption. But the corruption they dealt with was mainly the corruption caused by people having black money, stealing from the nation and hiding it elsewhere. In 2004, they completed the work. India hardly participated in that work. But my friends, as soon as the United Nations gave a declaration that we have prepared the Convention Against Corruption and Black Money, the Congress Party was the first to announce that they have signed the convention. But they were cheating the nation. The United Nations Convention does not become binding on anybody until a document of ratification is lodged formally in the office of the United Nations. Merely signing a document does not make it binding on the nation. And my friends, they pretended that they are seeking to get the culprits who have stolen this black money, and they will bring them to punishment. But this was all a total falsehood. Nothing of the kind was ever intended by them. My friends, in the meantime, the German government, more worried about black money than India, you will be surprised that Germans were much richer than us, but they were concerned with the black money problem. And my friends, the problem was such that the German government went out of its way and gave a bribe of $475 million to an employee of the notorious Liechtenstein Bank in Switzerland, on the outskirts of Switzerland. And that employee provided the German government with a list of 1,400 rascals who had stolen this black money from their country and hidden it in the Liechtenstein Bank. The German government looked at this list, made an announcement that the majority of the names in this list of 1,400 are of Indians. And India is a friendly government. We are prepared to give this information to the Indian government the moment they ask for it. Believe you me, neither the ruling party nor the opposition party approached the Germans for that information, which would have been of great use to us at that time. But on the contrary, the signature on this document, which means nothing at all, was treated as propaganda that they are very serious to get at this black money. Nothing of that kind happened. I had gone to Germany myself. I was a practicing lawyer, but at the same time I was a member of parliament, and I considered it my duty to investigate this fact. I went to Germany, and the German government told me that neither the ruling government nor the opposition BJP has ever approached us for this information. We are willing to share it, but they don't seem to care. So I told the Germans, I said, listen, please understand one thing, that India is a democracy and you have obligations to the people of India and not to the government of India, because I have come to tell you that my government itself is corrupt. You must give the names to the people of India. The Germans immediately agreed, and they told me that, Mr. Jethmalani, kindly go back, get two or three opposition leaders like yourself to write a letter to us that we want the information for the people of India, and Mr. Jethmalani is right, he is wanting them for the people of India, and what he is asking you to do, please do it for us. I came back happy. I thought that at least the BJP will be very happy. I drafted three letters and gave to the three leaders of the BJP party and told them that the Germans are waiting for this letter from three of you, and please send this letter within a week and you will get the names of the rascals who have stolen the money of the poor Indians. My friends, after a week I inquired from all the three BJP leaders. Don't ask me their names. I hate to even utter their name. Then they told me, all three of them, that we forgot. Forgot? Three persons can't forget the same thing at the same time. And my said friends, I said, all right, a week is gone by. Today is the eighth day. Now send me this document which I want to give to the Germans. That document has not come to me. If we are now in the end of almost getting to be 2017. My friends, that is the kind of society of rulers which we have had. And I went to the Supreme Court of India as a plaintiff, as a petitioner. My matter had to be argued for nearly 2 years, because I was opposed not merely by the Congress Party, which was at that time defendant number one, but also by defendant number two, the BJP, because none of them wanted the black money and the black dacoits to be caught. But my friends, they found that Jethmalani is receiving a great judgment from the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court had agreed to pronounce the judgment in July 2011. And a few months, 2 or 3 months before July 2011, you don't know what the president of the... I'm almost ashamed to utter these facts, that the president of the huge Congress party sent for the finance minister of Switzerland, entered into a secret deal. The two terms of that secret deal were: India will seek no information about the past, but only about the future. What do you think? He's making a fool of the country. Clause number 2, that India will not seek any information under the United Nations Convention Against Corruption, but only under what is called the Double Taxation Avoidance Treaty, which, my friends, is a document under Section 90 of the Income Tax Act. It is not an international document. It has nothing to do with black money and robbers. And all that it has to do is to provide some convenient settlement between a person who on the same income has to pay income tax in more than one country. It has nothing to do with black money. And so, my friends, this is what happened, the secret fraud. And after the fraud was perpetrated, the next morning the newspapers announced, see how the party is anxious to recover black money. They did not tell them what the secret deals were, what the secret protocol was. And my friends, ultimately Jethmalani discovered that secret protocol. I told you the terms were 2, which means that we gave up all possible method of getting at the identity of these rascals. So my friends, the government of India had suffered because of the action of its rulers. And after that, I'm short of time, but otherwise I have to relate to you stories which will shock you. But my friends, what happened was that ultimately Mr. Arun Jaitley became the finance minister of India, Modi's finance minister. Modi had seen my work in the Supreme Court. And Modi found out that Ram Jethmalani's friendship at this time will be a great asset to him. He found me out and said, Mr. Jethmalani, I am your partner in the fight against corruption. I want to fight for black money and I want your help and you help me. My friends, I have complete guilty for having committed that sin, that I agreed to help Mr. Modi on that day. I thought he was genuine. I thought he was serious. But he turned out to be a rogue, which he still is. Nothing of the kind happened. And my friends, fortunately, the work of collecting this black money is still on. And I can't take you into the details because the time at my disposal is extremely short. I myself have to catch a flight back to Delhi. But some other time, I will sit with you. But at the present moment, I want to tell you something much more important. Today, when Mr. Arun Jaitley became the finance minister of India, a friendly member of his in the Rajya Sabha asked him deliberately a question to give him some publicity. He was a friend of Arun Jaitley. He told him, Mr. Jaitley, please, now that you have become the finance minister of India, what steps are you taking to recover this black money? Do you know the reply of the crook? The reply of the crook was that I am entering into the amended Double Taxation Avoidance Treaty. The amended Double Taxation Avoidance Treaty means that avoidance treaty modified by the secret protocol which the Prime Minister of BJP, Congress party had already entered into. And my friends, when that answer was heard by me in Parliament, my blood boiled and I was a regular writer in the newspaper called Sunday Guardian. I was the chairman of the board of directors of that newspaper for years, and I used to write my monthly, weekly piece, which used to appear on the front, the middle editorial page of this illustrated weekly, of that document, of that newspaper. And my friends, when I wrote that article and sent it to my editor, I found that that particular article disappeared from the space which was allotted to me for all time, for years and years. And on the contrary, there was a paid advertisement filling up that in my space. And I knew what had happened. This clever finance minister of India had a secret deal with one of the employees of my newspaper that when Mr. Jethmalani writes any article against me, please inform me so that I cut it short. And my friends, that is exactly what happened. I don't want to tell you the name of the person who did this act of animosity against me and betrayed me and betrayed the nation. So my friends, today the fact remains that we have lost by contract, which I told you, secret deal and amended double taxation avoidance treaty. And when Mr. Arun Jaitley found that Mr. Jethmalani has come to know the fraud that I'm perpetrating on the people of India, do you know that no newspaper in this country, I'm not talking of every newspaper, but the most important newspapers in the country, refused to write to publish my article. Ultimately, I called the editor of the Indian Express and told him, I said, young man, when your father was alive, the Indian Express used to belong to me. And I have fought all my political battles through the Indian Express. And now you are refusing to publish my article. Please publish it as a paid advertisement. I am prepared to pay you advertisement charges. With great difficulty, my friends, he published my article against Arun Jaitley with the huge headline, "This is being published as a paid advertisement by Mr. Jethmalani." I don't care. Do you know that it cost me 13 lakhs to pay some kind of a bribe and temptation before that article of mine was published? But my friends, Mr. Arun Jaitley should have gone on that day, and Mr. Modi should have asked for his resignation on that day. But he as well as Modi were parties to a serious crime against the nation. And I wish to talk to you at great length, but I have no time today. I want to tell you that I am a fool, that my intelligence as one of the best lawyers of the country deserted me at the proper time. And I allowed this fraud to take place against the Indian nation, that this man continues, and he is continuing because Mr. Modi is with him. And now, to cut the story short, I have only one ambition in life, to apologize to the entire nation again and again for the folly that I have committed in getting Mr. Arun Jaitley as the Finance Minister of India and Modi as the Prime Minister of India. They must both go. They will go when you wake up. And to cut the story short today, for shortage of time again, I am thinking of developing a third force, because whatever might happen, in every political party there are good people, but they have lost their nerve, they have lost their capacity to speak truth, because it harms men, harms them. They are not prepared to suffer any loss today. They have become selfish. But that selfishness has to be conquered. It is being slowly conquered. And today, I must tell you that a third front will be developed with the help of honest people and politicians like Mr. Pulala, who is here, the leader of the CVK? KVC.
VCK.
See, I have mastered all these in one evening. So, I think he deserves to be India's future Prime Minister, if you ask me. But provided that he does not also turn like Arun Jaitley. So my friends, to cut the story short, I am now in pursuit of the development of a third force. God willing, I will be able to announce, and I will also be able to announce a Prime Minister who should take the place of Modi and send him to jail. Who that person is going to be, I cannot possibly tell you now, because be sure that the third force will come into existence before 2019, before the next election, and be sure that this crooked Prime Minister, as well as his crooked colleagues, will ultimately go to jail, if not suffer further punishment. But please, please show your contempt of these people and make it possible for the third force to develop. And the third force will develop. I will take you into confidence. But today, pardon me that A, I have not been very well, and that is why my voice sometimes breaks. But I have come also to seek your apology that at the age of 95, how did I allow myself to be fooled by these two persons, and how the whole nation has been defrauded, and those defaulters and defraud players are still in power, and it is in your power now to dislodge them and to deal with them. And I am there in your service. Be sure that before I die, I will have developed the third force. I will have found out a substitute Prime Minister with, of course, the concurrence and help of the gentleman who leads this particular party.
VCK.
And the VCK.
Yes,
and the VCK. And the VCK boss. And please bear this in mind. I have come here to offer my apologies to you for having committed an act of insanity. And pardon me, I will make good, and that's my promise to you and to God. And thank you.
நேரத்தில் கொடுத்துருக்கணும் நான் கொடுத்துருக்கேன்.